Hey there, I'm Lisa from HubSpot, and welcome to the latest edition of the Product Spotlight. In this video, my fellow HubSpotters and I will walk you through this month's biggest and most exciting product updates, but from the safe physical distance of our own homes. We've got a lot to cover this month, including a personal tour of HubSpot's brand new account-based marketing features. So let's dive right in.
Hi everyone, it's Ryan on the product marketing team. On May 19th, we launched a brand new set of account-based marketing features. Today, I wanted to take a moment to talk through some of the biggest features that we launched and that are now available to Marketing Hub Professional and above and Sales Hub and Professional above users to help marketing and sales teams come together to deliver more consistent, personalized buying experiences for your highest value accounts. Because I'll only be covering the highlights today, I'd encourage you to check out our new product page shown here. The Target Accounts Home is the command center for your marketing and sales teams to come together to monitor progress on, you guessed it, Target Accounts. In order to set up your Target Accounts Home, and all other ABM features for that matter, you will need a super admin or a user with account access permissions to activate them by navigating in-app to Contacts, and then the Target Accounts tab underneath that, and clicking on Get Started. The onboarding process will then walk the admin through how to set up the Target Accounts home. Once set up, you can go in and mark companies as Target Accounts in bulk through updating the Target Account property of the company record to true. You can also mark companies by manually clicking on the Choose Target Accounts button in the upper right corner of your Target Accounts home. Lastly, if you need some guidance to identify potential good fit customers, you can go to the bottom left of Target Accounts home and select either Prospects to look at potential prospects, or you can click Recommendations to view HubSpot's new AI-powered recommendations of accounts based on data in your HubSpot account. Once you've added your target accounts, you can view high-level metrics at the top of the target account's home, or you can engage with the account by simply hovering over a target account and clicking on the Actions drop-down. If you have Sales Hub Professional or Enterprise, paid seat users get access to a deep dive account overview panel on each target account's company record. You can access this through your target account's home, the right panel of a company record, or in Salesforce, if you've installed the Salesforce HubSpot integration and added the new HubSpot Account Overview Visual Force window. The Account Overview gives you a snapshot of engagement with a specific account, the activities, deals, and contacts associated to the company, as well as the internal stakeholders involved with those activities, and even tracked page views from those contacts. It's a great place to check in and monitor how your team's efforts are progressing with a specific account. You can now create company-based lists in HubSpot. And once your ABM tools are activated, your HubSpot account will automatically create lists based on ABM properties, like target account or buying role. You can view these lists in the account-based advertising list folder. These lists can help you segment based on company or contacts for more personalized and relevant engagement, whether that's sending marketing emails, creating company-based ad audiences through our LinkedIn integration, or customizing smart content on site. Lists can now help you really advance your account-based marketing strategy and bring it to the next level. Once you activate your ABM features, you can easily report on progress with our new out-of-the-box ABM dashboard and library of reports, all based on ABM properties. To create and save the account-based marketing dashboard, navigate over to Reports in App and then to Dashboards. Click Create a New Dashboard, and in the Dashboard Library, select Account-Based Marketing. Conveniently, starting with A, it's the first one. From here, you can customize which reports you want to see. With a pre-built set of reporting tools at your fingertips, you and your team can quickly evaluate what's working and what's not with your ABM strategy.
The key to an efficient sales team is a clean database. And to keep your database clean as your team scales, you need to make sure that the right users have access to exactly the right set of data in your account. If a sales rep has access to something that she shouldn't, that could distract her from actually selling and put key reporting and processes at risk. With an update this past month, admins can now lock down the values of specific properties to certain reps so that everyone on your team sees exactly what they should. Assigning permissions to properties is just like assigning permissions to anything else in your HubSpot account. Here's how it works. Navigate to Settings and Properties. Click the checkbox next to one or more properties, then click Assign Users and Teams. Select the users and teams who can edit values and click Save. Note that these permissions only impact who can edit properties for now. They don't yet impact who can view properties. Field level edit permissions are now available to enterprise accounts across all HubSpot tiers. Enjoy. Reporting is your company's compass. It helps you to determine what's working and what's not so that you can optimize all your marketing, sales, and service activities in the future. To get the right insights to steer your business in that way, you need a reporting tool that grows with you, that grows right alongside you. And this month, we are excited to introduce several updates to make your HubSpot reporting limits clearer and more robust. Here's what you can expect to see. First, more dashboards, period. The only limit to your dashboard experience should be your imagination, not your HubSpot cap. So with this change, if you are a starter, a professional, or an enterprise customer, you can now build more than twice as many dashboards inside of HubSpot, plain and simple. Second, more flexible and consistent dashboards. In the past, you've had two different types of dashboards in HubSpot, standard and custom. It's just confusing, to be honest. So with today's change, there is no longer a distinction between standard and custom. Third, more robust dashboards for professional accounts. With today's update, if you're on a professional subscription, you can now add 20 reports to any dashboard. That limit was previously 10. And as an added bonus, you can now create up to 100 custom reports. Previously, that limit was 20. And finally, an even better reporting add-on. If you're a reporting add-on user, you've got even more room to grow with these updates. You can now create up to 300 dashboards. Previously, that was 200. And 3,000 custom reports. Previously, that was 2,000. These updates are now live to new and existing HubSpot accounts as of May 19th, 2020. Thank you. At HubSpot, our mission is to help millions of businesses around the world to grow better. And that's not just the English-speaking world, that's the whole world. So if you're a HubSpot user, you should be able to use HubSpot in the language that you speak every day or that you're most comfortable with. And with that in mind, over the years, we've localized HubSpot into 6 languages: English, German, Portuguese, Spanish, French, and Japanese. And in May, we have added a 7th. The HubSpot platform is now fully localized in the Dutch language. To change your HubSpot account into Dutch or any other language, click the gear icon in the upper right. Select your language from the language dropdown and click Save. Your HubSpot account now in Dutch.
Hi everyone, it's Alex on the product marketing team. I hope you're all doing well. Last month, we talked to you about the new CMS Hub and walked you through a few of the new features available in CMS Hub Professional. Well, today, I want to talk to you about the all-new CMS Hub Enterprise and show you some of the features that allow scaling businesses to create web app experiences on their website and also get more control over their growing teams. First, let's talk about security. Now, the entire HubSpot platform is secure, but as your business grows, you might need more customization options when it comes to the security of your website. That's why we've added new domain security settings to add an additional and customizable layer of security to your website, protecting visitors and your brand online. Settings include HSTS, refer and content security policies, and more. To get started, go to your domains and URL settings, and next to any domain, click Edit, Update Domain Security Settings. Next up is our newly released Activity Logs API, also available in CMS Hub Enterprise. This new logging system records each time a piece of content was created, updated, published, or deleted in your HubSpot account. Use this API to create your own custom workflow management or monitoring solution, to integrate with an existing solution, or just to track down who on your team was the last person to update the website. To get started, check out the Activity Logs API doc. and to learn more about all the ways CMS Hub helps you create a website that's fast, secure, and reliable, check out the CMS Hub for IT Teams page linked in the description below.
Hi, everyone. I'm Will, the product manager for the CMS developer tools here at HubSpot. I wanted to share a couple of the features available in CMS Hub Enterprise and how you can use them together to create powerful app-like functionality on websites. First, a new feature, serverless functions, which provide a way to write server-side code that interacts with HubSpot and third-party services through APIs. Serverless functions enable you to build more sophisticated websites on CMS Hub. Second, memberships is an enterprise feature that lets you easily create login portals on your website, all powered by your CRM contacts and lists. You grant access to gated content based on list membership, and contacts with access to your gated content create logins to view the content they have access to. Combining serverless functions and memberships enables you to build web app experiences on your website. We built a sample open source event registration app that utilizes both of these features to display events, allow for registering for events, keeping track of how much space is an event, and allowing registrants to view the classes they've registered for. I cannot wait to see the disruptive experiences you all build on CMS Hub Enterprise. Enjoy.
This month, we also launched a brand new HubSpot-built integration for SignalFX. This integration lets CMS Hub Enterprise customers sync their website performance data into SignalFX, so IT teams can continue to use the technology they prefer to use when monitoring their site's uptime and performance. To get started, check out the app listing link in the description below.
Hi, everyone. My name is Joe, and I'm a product marketing manager here at HubSpot. I've got some awesome updates to share with you today. Let's start with Service Hub. With this update, you can now add attachments to your Jira issue directly from within HubSpot. By sharing things like files and screenshots, you can provide increased context to illustrate your issue. To add an attachment, simply drag and drop it into the attachments field or upload it from your desktop or file folder. Next up, we've got an awesome update to the SEO tool. With this update, the SEO audit tool will no longer display SEO recommendations for pages that are blocked from appearing in search results. This makes it easier for you to focus your SEO efforts on the pages that matter. So how do you use this feature? Well, if your content is hosted on HubSpot, no action is necessary. Your pages are already doing this. And if you have externally hosted pages, all you need to do is click the Scan for Recommendations button to get up-to-date SEO suggestions. That's it for me. Take care.
Hello, Sam here. So today I'd like to introduce to you the web version for marketing email now available in Marketing Starter. So first of all, what is the web version? So the web version feature that enables marketers to include a view in browser link at the top of your marketing emails that will link a recipient out to an identical version of the email, but as a web page instead. So with this update, we're bringing this feature to the Marketing Hub Starter tier. Why does it matter? So the web version link in an email is a great safety net for customers. No matter what, even if things go wrong, even if the inbox can't properly render something, your recipients will always have the ability to view a clean and unaltered version of the email in their web browser. So how does it work? So as a starter customer, you can head to the settings tab of the editor on any email you're working on, and under advanced settings, you'll find a toggle where you can switch on the web version and give the page a title, URL, and meta description. Now I'd like to explain another product update, a few small but important updates to exporting files across marketing email. To the main email export from the email managed page, the following changes are included. First, introducing the click-through rate as a new column in the export. And second, adding new data related to the multiple preference centers rollout. And then next, to the recipient's export from the email's post-send page, we have removed the forwarded column. The next time you request an export, you should see this change automatically. Now I'd like to explain another product update, expanded ads reporting metrics. So first of all, what is it? Being able to see metrics when looking at ad spend data is critical for marketers to make sound decisions. Marketers now have the ability to see cost per MQL, cost per SQL, cost per deal, cost per lead, cost per opportunity, and cost per session. So how does it work? From the ads tool homepage, click on Add Metrics and select the new metrics you wish to add. After hitting Save, the new metrics will appear in your reporting. Who gets it? Marketing Hub Pro and Enterprise users.
That's all for today, folks. As always, if you can't get enough HubSpot product updates, you can check out our product updates blog using the link in the description below. Also, keep an eye out for our monthly newsletter that highlights some of our most exciting product updates to help you stay informed. We'll see you next month.